In 2011, University of Otago, they investigated the frequency of people smoking motor vehicles carrying children. The outcome of that report showed that Wainuiomata was 11 times higher than Karori of people smoking in motor vehicles carrying children.
I used to see like a lot of people smoking cars with underage kids.
After rugby games, league games, just the parents smoking with their hand out the window.
I was getting emails, phone calls, people stopping me in the street, really concerned about that issue for Wainuiomata. So the actual project came due to a community response. People smoking in cars, it's obviously about Māori because we have the highest stats of smokers. And for me, the most prominent group would be obviously the Wainuiomata League because their members are predominantly Māori and Pacific. And so I spoke to their club captain at the time, Simon Aitula, and just said, sure, what do you want me to do? And I said, look, it's just simple messaging on your junior grounds, just saying like, you know, make your grounds smoke-free, let them know that you're supporting a smoke-free car campaign.
Parents were aware of that it wasn't allowed, so they would approach visiting parents to tell them, hey, we don't smoke on the grounds, take it to the car park. Players' parents also told them, you know, have a smoke before you get in the car.
But behind all the scenes actually was the hashtags. Now, it's a group of youth, and we've had 35 members over the 10 years. And they were the face of the campaign. We decided, we said, well, why don't we use them to help champion this project?
I was pretty much one of the founding members. Started off as a small group, and you know, we were all kind of passionate about the campaigns.
At first I just went for the food, but then I listened more and I found interest.
We had support from all over the community, mainly the Wainuiomata Rugby League Club, which they kind of championed us. We did a few community events. We had little pop-ups in the library, the community centre.
Trips to Parliament and going on trips with UNICEF. We always went back to smoke-free cars and presenting that as one of our biggest matters.
When we requested for the University of Otago to come back and do a retake, the result was that they found that the number had reduced to over half.
So that just goes to show that, you know, our little input in the community really did help bring those stats down.
This final group, like they're like the babies now, they're the ones that actually presented their oral submissions to government. And so they wrote their own speeches, were absolutely amazing, all very different, and they presented to the select committee.
It was real nerve-wracking actually, because I had done public speaking before that, but it wasn't to big people in charge.
You know, of course it's Parliament, you know, and they walk in and of course you're going through security. Well, for those that hadn't been before, they thought, wow, it's like the movies. Because they're whispering, they go, oh, they're old people. Oh, look, where's the other youth? You know, isn't there anybody else our age, you know?
When we got in there, Josh done our introduction, and because Josh was confident, it made me feel confident as well.
Nerve-wracking, to be honest. Like, that was my first time speaking in public. They made a lot of eye contact with me. And they told us it was on live too, to the whole New Zealand. Shocking.
We could tell they were engaged because they were asking questions at the end as well. So we felt good afterwards because we felt like we didn't just go there just to talk. We went there and they got the message that we sent.
Tariyama Turia, yes, she was there. And the Children's Commissioner, Judge Breedcroft, gave us some advice afterwards.
He just kept praising them. He couldn't believe it. He said, oh my goodness, we need more groups like you to help.
They like told us that they like really enjoyed it and they think they might actually back us up in it. Our speeches and that helped them to move on with the journey.
I think it would have been around 2 weeks we had to wait, but once we got notified, it was great news. We knew that those 8 to 10 years was worth it after all. I felt like I could do anything after that.
I'm happy that, you know, that they've picked up this team, I guess, to, you know, showcase what they can bring into the community, and you know, we started something that they could potentially finish or keep on going.
Working with the rangatahi is that I've never ever underestimated them. They're the only youth group that have ever changed law from little Wainuiomata. What can you say about that?